Welcome to Community Balance. I'm Suzanne Barnett, your host, and I am so happy to present three very, very talented, important people from the Foundation Fighting Blindness. So let's meet them right now. First, we're going to have Lisa Lloyd. Tell us your position.
Sure. I'm the Director of Development for Northern California for Foundation Fighting Blindness.
And our star, Dean Lloyd, what is your position?
I'm not involved with the Foundation Fighting Blindness other than contributing my donated services. And my position, I'm a regular practicing attorney in Palo Alto for many years, and I am a participant in the Food and Drug Administration clinical trial for a prosthetic retinal implant, which I currently have on, and it's currently operating, and this is the original or basic device to bring back to persons who are totally blind some sort of vision. It's the second series called Argus 2. There is an Argus 1, and this has more electrodes, and it's supposed to be more effective. It does work. It doesn't work like normal vision would be expected to work, but it gives a form of vision which is helpful to persons who have lost their vision completely in a condition called retinitis pigmentosa, advanced age-related macular degeneration, or some other condition which has caused the retina to cease to operate. It's called retinal degenerative conditions.
I could never remember that name, but we're gonna find out all about you in just a moment. And I'm so happy to welcome Miss Heather Spearman. I see I don't forget your name. And you're the special events big shot director for the foundation, right?
Yes, I am.
So, you know, well, why don't you talk about what you do first?
Okay. Well, as you're going to hear, it does take $3 to $4 million to operate one human clinical trial that Dean will speak about later. And what my job is to primarily raise awareness and research dollars for these human clinical trials and other research studies. I do this through four events in Northern California. We have an ultimate fantasy hockey playoff where we partner with the San Jose Sharks. Dan Rusinowski, the voice of the Sharks, is one of our co-chairs. I also do a Dining in the Dark Visionary Awards Dinner Gala at the Ritz-Carlton in San Francisco. And that event is a little bit different. It's a normal dinner gala where we honor two members of the community that have been outstanding in science and technology and advancements in helping us with our research. But we have a twist to it, which is the Dining in the Dark aspect. So after our awards are presented and the speeches are done, the lights go out, all the exit signs are taped off, and your visually impaired server comes to your table and places your dinner in front of you. And you, it is your responsibility to negotiate your fork and knife in complete darkness. So it's kind of an eye-opening experience for those who are not affected with retinal degenerative disease.
Well, tell us the date.
That event is on Wednesday, April 22nd in San Francisco at the Ritz-Carlton. It starts at 6 p.m. with our cocktail reception, and the awards ceremony begins at 7.
Well, this foundation, which I had never heard of except about half an hour ago, it's so important. It really is. So, Lisa, tell us about you.
Sure. Well, my job is to drive the research to find a treatment or a cure for people with these retinal degenerative diseases. So I oversee the Major Gifts Program. And then I also oversee our chapter work here in Northern California. So we have four chapters, one in Silicon Valley, one in the East Bay, one in San Francisco, and one in Sacramento. And the chapters disseminate information about this research that's going on and the human clinical trials, as well as fundraise for all these different events that Heather just mentioned. And we also have a vision walk, which we're going to be offering this spring, so we're very excited about that.
Now, this is your dad.
This is
the blind guy, right?
Dad,
but you have such a good sense of humor about it, which we're going to find out in a minute. But Lisa, you have a similar condition. Could you tell us about that?
Sure. We have several people in our family who are affected at different levels with retinitis pigmentosa, which is known as RP. So typically it affects our peripheral vision and our night vision. For me, it's a very different expression. It's called mosaic form, and I only have a 50% expression. But it's very difficult for me to see at night, so I don't do a lot of night driving. And so this is the kind of diseases, you know, that a lot of our constituents end up having and have to live with on a regular basis.
Is yours a progressive
disease? It is. And there's no telling, you know, if I'm always going to have vision as good as I have it now, or, you know, if it's just going to get worse. But there are six people in my family who are affected, and we have six young boys, and each one of them has a 50% chance of having RP. So we could have as many as 12 in our family. So as you can see, we definitely have to fulfill this mission, and I'm deeply committed to that.
How do you deal with that, with the possibility of becoming blind, like your dad?
Yeah, I think you have to prepare yourself. So for me, that meant I wanted to get enough education behind me. So if I had to support myself, then I could do so. So I got a master's in counseling, and I figured I could always counsel people who are blind and visually impaired if I needed to. So that was just something to fall back on. But I have so many other people in my family that are blind or visually impaired. It really is very helpful. So for one, we walk each year in our vision walk as an affected family and raise dollars for the research. And we share with each other how we're getting by and teach each other whatever we can. So, yeah.